What's up, guys? So I haven't posted anything about our S197 since we did the half mile stuff, since my wife drove the half mile and went 203. The car's been kind of sitting. We wanted to go try some no prep stuff, so we went to just a typical test and tune at our local track, US 131 Motorsports Park, and threw some 28 10.5s on it. I made a bar change in the back, a shock adjustment, pulled the travel limiters out of it, and we left the 315 gear in it. Now remember, this has got a turbo 400 in it with a 165 first gear, meaning with the 315 gear and 8,000 RPM shift point, it does a little over 100 mile an hour in low. The thought process there was just to give us a wider tuning window for the, you know, no prep style surface. I've never done a no prep thing in my life, so we were just playing to see how it would go. Here's the first pass we made with it from an in-car, and kind of listen to the engine. You can hear how long first gear is. It just takes forever and it leaves super, super soft. So yeah, listen to this for a second and then I'll show you an external shot and kind of go through what we're seeing suspension wise there. So here's a side shot of this thing. Watch how soft it hits the tire, and then you can see it kind of wrinkle the tire a bit as it gets rolling. I'll show you it here at full speed, and then we'll slow it down and we'll watch it at like half speed or something. Okay, so watch it hit the tire. The initial movement is relatively violent, which I don't really, again, I haven't no prep raced enough to really know if that's too violent or not. In my opinion, watching that, I need to put a little bit more rebound in the shock so it doesn't hit the tire so hard. You can see it kind of, it hits the tire hard and sets, and then the body kind of falls on it. Watch this. Actually, it doesn't fall on it. As you watch that again, you'll see that the tire actually bounces, so it's definitely hitting the tire too hard, so I need to put some more rebound in the shock and then let it rip. But again, it's 315 gear in the thing, so this was leaving on 12 pounds, ramped to 27 over a second and a half, which that power ramp's probably too aggressive for a no prep surface. This was a typical test and tune deal. The surface was honestly better than I thought it was going to be. It was too good to do what we were trying to test for. But all in all, the thing went okay. This pass here, like I said, was a 12 PSI leave, ran to 27 over a second and a half. I bailed at 6.7 seconds and coasted to like an 880 at 135. It went a 570, 131, 132 to the eighth. So not a bad lick, really. But again, the service was too good. It really didn't accomplish what we wanted to do. The other downside to this, the big problem that we had, honestly, with this gearing setup, was the trans temp. At that pass there, we had two things going on. My external dump wasn't working, which is why it took so long to get on the two-step. To just 12 pounds took forever. So it was making more temp on the hit, but also the gear change causes the converter to just have to work that much harder in low gear. So that pass there, by the time I got to the end of the track and turned around, the trans temp was 220 degrees. And it still only went a 570. I really want to see like a 530 at that power level, which we can do with a gear change. So that was pretty much it for our no prep thing. When I saw the trans temp was a problem, we just loaded up and went home. We're going to put the 410 gears in the car and probably throw the radials back on it for an event in a couple weeks and see how that goes. And the only other goal we have this car, or this year with the car, is to go sevens, which I don't think will be a problem, but we've yet to do it, so we'll see what happens.